Thank you. is your source. Of course, I got another one of my Love Responds t-shirts. To help our capital campaign, this is one of the ones you can get. A Love Responds. If it doesn't respond, it's not love, or it will teach you what love is not, which is the reason it's not responding. These are our t-shirts. ADBQ is hashtag a Darius Brooks quote, colon, which is one of the things God has given me to share, that love really does respond. You know the saying, love hurts, that's not true, that's the world's language. And the truth hurts, that's not true, that's the world's language. Love is kind, love is patient, love really does these things. And it's a challenge learning them to be your best in doing this. It also differentiates, love also corrects. Yes, sir. Sometimes when we're doing things out of order, love will correct us. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. In a good way, not a negative way. I love when I'm corrected because it helps me be a better me. Because if I'm not corrected, I was always taught if you don't straighten out a bad situation, it only gets worse. So I just want to be my best in Christ. I want to do my best that whole nine, okay? There's sometimes you have to stand your ground, though, and not let people just walk over you and do things. You have to stand your ground, okay? All right, I love you. Let us pray. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for your word, being a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our pathway. You are our source in every area of our lives. We continue to understand, learn, grow, and embrace, trust, believe, and obey, that it's in you that we move, live, and have our being if we are the believer that we trust in you. All right? We love you. We give you honor and glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank God for Grace Central and the promises of his word being invited into our hearts, that it produces just what he says. You guys, being a server, a servant, is crazy amazing. As a matter of fact, he articulates, he that is great among you, let him be a server, not necessarily be served, but be a server. Great revelation, great insight for one to want the best from God, okay? All right, Tuesdays, we our capital campaign, we are doing some wonderful things over here. Every Tuesday from 5 till 7, we are feeding people. You're welcome to come. If you know anybody who needs food, it's here at Grace Central Church. Every Tuesday from 5 till 7, on Wednesdays from noon till 2. The seniors can come and eat and get food, and we can make sure everybody is fulfilled and getting what they need physically as well as spiritually, okay? All right, let's journey through the good news. Let's journey through the good news, all right? I love the Word of God, rightly dividing it so it can give me inspiration and be very impactful in my daily walk when it comes to God, okay? And let it be, when these signs are come unto thee, that thou do as occasion serve thee, for God is with thee. Okay? I want to use for a thought today. God bless me with this one right here. When I don't get the credit, I'll never stop being my best. When I don't get the credit, I'll never stop being my best. All right? When I tell you the Word of God, when you get into it, it's like a book. When you ever wanted to do something, whether it's a idea, and you wanted to learn the instructions on it or how to do it, the Word of God is kind of like that. Whenever you want to use some instructions or get some insight or direction, you got to go to the Word of God, open it up, and say, how do I do this? How do I put this together? How do I use this ink thing? It's the same way with the Word of God, which is crazy information in there that we could utilize for ourselves. Watch this. And let it be, with these signs are come unto thee. Or when you start seeing things and observing things, the Word of God says, okay, look at it, see it, observe it, but let it be. What does that mean? Watch this. that thou do as occasion serve thee, or whatever the occasion is, God's word, this is what we're reading right now, and let it be, let God's word be, when these signs are coming to thee, or whenever you see signs of things, whether it's negative or positive, good or bad, he says, that thou dost as occasion serve thee, or whichever occasion comes up to us or presents itself to us, thee, he says, let God's word be, for God is with thee. Or don't let that situation in no kind of way affect you that you have to do anything outside of God's word to make it or fix it. Yeah. Sometimes when we're doing ourselves and our flesh, we could mess up some things. Yeah. 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 And for not just for us, for everybody else too. You know, sometimes, believe it or not, did you know that when you put yourself in harm's way, somebody else more often than not is affected by it? Mm-hmm. You know, this is a place to the believer that you really want God's direction and guidance. I know I do. Because I know my flesh, I know me, but I it doesn't matter what happens in my life. I just want God's word on it because I know the word of God says there's no other way by which men can be saved but through here. And I know it's true because I've tried a lot of things my way only to wind up with what I got, but it's not really what I wanted at the end of the day. Yeah. So I know that when these signs come before us or opportunities or things that we see, when they come unto us, that when these occasions God calls them serve us or come up to us, he says, let God's word be. That's what he means when he says, and let it be. Let God's word or what I'm sharing with you be. Because if you put his word in front of anything and you trust him, God going to be with you. His word is going to be with you. It's going to do more, as I always share with you, protecting than rewarding. The rewards of God are amazing because they come without craziness. The blessing of the Lord, the principles of all God's word, it maketh rich and addeth no sorrow with it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You ever ran a red light and didn't get a ticket or nothing like that? Because you're that right there. Okay. Not that we're not human. It's just that he knows how to take real good care of us. Considering the people who you see regularly, if you go to school, church, your job, the neighborhood, the kids, you around the team you have with you, often the reason they're there is because these are the close relationships, watch this, that we have an opportunity to develop. Getting away from people, places, and things are situations and occasions and experiences that's unhealthy for us, but often, if we're clear, the right kind of people around us, we have to be very careful with, because there's a reason they're there. And before we get to running away from people and getting away from things, it's a strong possibility that some of us have had some good relationships and we didn't treat them well, or we thought that they should just put up with our foolishness. Or I'm the kind of person that I've been good to you, and I am good to you, but occasionally you act like you have selective amnesia. So we have to be careful of the relationships that are around us or close to us, because often if they're close to us, there's a reason they're close to us. And we're to nurture, condition, and develop them the way God wants them done. I have to do my portion in it. You have to do your portion in it. And when one of us don't, we'll feel it. We'll feel it. We have an opportunity to develop things, experience, and situations that are close to us. Before it go away, yeah, God gives us an opportunity to take real good care of them and manage them well. I'm to do my part and you to do your part. And he says, who do you pay attention to that when you're in a situation, you know you should be doing some things and you're not? You know you should keep your word and you're not. You know you could have done that differently. And yeah, I often share with people, when you have done something wrong, ask for forgiveness and ask what can you do to fix it. Long as it's godly, that you do not owe people that you know you haven't done nothing wrong to. But the word of God says that if you have an ought against your brother, go to him. So if you haven't done anything wrong and they've done something to you, you don't owe them anything. But the Word of God says if you love that brother or you want to continue a relationship, go to them and talk to them. Work that thing out. Who do you enjoy being around? Who do you enjoy sharing things with? Who do you enjoy having things in common with? Who seems genuinely interested in you? And who is it that you, for real, are genuinely interested in? Watch this. You'll see these signs. They'll come to you. You'll know those who you can, those who you can't. You know the relationships you want to keep, even if it's crazy. You know the relationships that are not worth it. He says, when these occasions serve thee, use God's word in it and he'll be with you. More importantly, I always share with you that whenever you read God's word, it's with you and him first. Hey, Darius, what signs are you seeing that's coming to you that these are really occasions that serve thee? But you won't let God's word be what it is because you know God is with you. That's how you see this. We as believers obey not because obeying saves us. Y'all check this out. We obey because of the way God's word saves us. We don't do it for it to save us. We do it because of the way God's word wants to save us. You catch it? Yeah. Because see, sometimes when God is doing some things through us, we're to get some of it, but it's more often than not for someone else. Did you know that every time you mature and grow, people will see your maturity and they'll say, oh, no, I remember when they used to do that. It's true. Mm-hmm. So when you see signs of things that's coming to you and God calls them occasions and they're there to serve you, you got to let God's word be his word because there is where God will be with you. So we're not saved because we technically want to be saved. But the way God's word save us is the way he wants to save us so the situation can be so much bigger. When God's word is your source, not only you, but everyone around you will know. Mm-hmm. People will know when they should have did that differently. Check this out. Sometimes God will put you in a place to put a person in their place just with truth. And they'll learn, well, that's not the kind of person I need to fool with. There's a sign. Yeah, mm-hmm. So there's a sign that I need to stand my ground and stand firm. And there's a sign that somebody might be able to put me in my place because I'm out of place. When these signs are coming to thee, that thou do as occasion serve thee. Do as what God's word says when these occasions serve thee. For when you do this, God is going to be with you because you want how he wants to save you, not how you want to be saved. Or save in situations. Just like Jesus, when they seen the signs following him, how can you say God is with you and there is nothing to prove he is? Money can't prove it. A house can't prove it. A good car can't prove it. Clothing can't prove it. You know, you got to always want to do these things over. None of these are proof that God is with us. So what proves God is with me? Or what proves God is with you? I'm glad you asked. John 3:2. I'm reminded. The same came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that thou art teacher and you came from God. For no man can do these miracles that thou dost except God be with you. Christmas is gone already and we're headed into a new year with crazy stuff that's about to happen with the same God that's over everything. For those of you who don't understand this experience, it's not just that we attend church, but we're to love our church, we're to serve where we are. We are to give where we are. We are to invite others where we are because we are proud of what we worship. We recognize that we're here to evangelize and to engage and participate in God's bigger picture. And it deals with every area of our lives, which is how the church will thrive in 2024, regardless and contrary to popular belief. He says, upon this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Like it should, the church will prevail. How? Because God is so much more, and he does so much more when we can take our situations and our circumstances and the signs of the things we see in front of us that God uses as occasions to serve us, that they're there for a reason, that we let God's word be what it's supposed to be in all of our ways. We acknowledge him, and he'll direct our path for him to always be with us and to always make sure it's a bigger picture and outcome that everybody will always see God. Starts with you, starts with me, in a real way, in real our real personal place and space, that when we get up from reading and studying, we can use God's word to share with us. When I don't get the credit, I'll never stop being my best me, because God, through his word, will be doing so much bigger and better things in my life when I look at signs and occasions and I don't let them affect me, but I do God's word so he can always show up. When I don't get the credit, I'll never stop being my best. Lord, we love you. We give you honor. We give you glory. Thank you for your direction. Thank you for never failing us. And thank you for every time we go to your word for direction, you are always there. Thank you that you are a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our pathway. Thank you that you have controlled the past, the present, and the future. And we know your voice because we are your sheep. And we are believers. This is our place. This is our story. And we're sticking to it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right. I hope you enjoyed that message. Please write us. Let us know you've enjoyed it. And let's do our actions for today. I'm excited. Use them. Timing is everything. I'm excited about my action book that's coming out. I wanted to do it before the new year was out, but I let God be God, and I let the sign show me that it's coming, just not now. Be patient with me and keep me in your prayers as he's directing me to release this book. I believe the timing is going to be perfect, okay? All right, here are our actions. Check them out. I finally found my love story, but I had to let some relationships in. Two. I cleaned up my spirit, not just my image. That right there, a preach. And here's three. I didn't find out how dangerous I was to me until I stopped lying to me. That's when I start living my best life. Say self, oh self. When I don't get the credit, I'll never stop being my best. Yeah. God says, consider the signs. Consider the situations that are there to serve you. That when you put God's word on it, he'll always show up. Ain't that crazy amazing? Alrighty. All right, every Tuesday, we want you to sow into the ministry. If this message has blessed you, you can send us a check, Cash App, Zelle us. You know how to do it. Here go the information that you need. You can Zelle us, Grace Central Church, info at gracecentral.net. You can credit debit us, online giving. You can also write a check or money order, 10216 South Kitchener Street, Westchester, Illinois. Or you can Cash App us, $ Grace Central Church. Or you can call us, the church, 708-344-5020. We still have a landline. You can call us. I know, right? Ah! These are ways to give. If we've been a blessing to you, where there's no appreciation, there's no investment. Where there's no investment, there's no appreciation. Everything that you appreciate that God has blessed you to receive some things from, invest in it. Don't just take, and not give. You'll never get God's best there, okay? All right? I hope you are blessed, and I hope you are able to use God's word in everything that you do. And my prayer is that today, when it seems like you don't get the credit, never stop being your very best. God will be with you there, okay? Every Tuesday, we give apple cider juice to toast to our messages, to our topics, and this Tuesday is no different. This Tuesday, a day after Christmas, that God is going to let you be your very best, even if you don't get the credit, he's going to show up. Cheers. Thank you.